Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. The Income Tax Department has taken up the reopened assessment for scrutiny of sources of money the investors had invested with Vas and Kar Group, most of which were deposited in cash. On receiving complaints from such aggrieved investors, Economic Affairs Wing of Nagpur Police has filed a FIR in MPID court and arrested such operators in May 2014 and are still in jail. Prashant Vasankar and others, the main operator of Ponzi scheme, have collected more than ₹128 crores and ran out of money, suspecting evasion of tax on cash when invested and interest received on such investments year on year. The Income Tax Department has taken stringent action since some investors has already stated that these investments were made in cash and the same is not reflected in the books or IT returns. This became potential case for Income Tax Department to take the tax evasion. Further investigation and proceedings are underway. Neghamthi police have booked some unidentified miscreants allegedly for looting a retired military official of his pistol gun, besides gold ring and cash ₹10,000 on Knife Point here on Tuesday night. According to police sources, complainant Sunil David, a former military official and a resident of Bhavankar layout, was alone at home when five armed miscreants stealthily intruded inside his house. The accused then threatened elderly David on Knife Point and decamped with his pistol, cash and a gold ring. On the basis of the complaint lodged by David, Neghamthi police have booked the unidentified accused under relevant sections of the Indian Penal Code and launched the manhunt for the accused persons. The Nagpur Municipal Corporation's Nuisance Detection Squad on Wednesday took action against 161 irresponsible citizens without masks and recovered a fine of ₹80,500 each from them. Masks were also given to all these citizens. In the last few months, search team have taken action against 24,104 citizens and so far a fine of ₹1,04,11,000 has been recovered. Although the number of corona patients has decreased, the risk of coronavirus infection has not been averted. Even now, safe distances are not observed in many of the places. In urban areas, it is alarming to see unmasked citizens walking around. Therefore, the nuisance detection team, under vision of Tambe, in taking strict actions against the citizens who are endangering. Therefore, the nuisance detection team under Veersen Tambe is taking strict action against the citizens who are endangering their own health, family health and the health of the society in such an irresponsible manner, and they are being given masks by the Nagpur Municipal Corporation officials. A city trader has been defrauded of ₹2.65 lakhs in the name of securing a plywood supply contract for the 2022 FIFA Soccer World Cup in Qatar. Police have registered a case on the basis of a complaint by Shivaji Nagar resident Prashant Muralidhar Rathi. According to information received, Rathi is a distributor of plywood. Last February, he received an email from a company called Raju Enterprises. The email had told the accused that the 2022 FIFA World Cup will be here in Qatar. There is a huge demand for plywood for the decoration of the stadium. For this, ₹2.65 lakhs will have to be paid first. Rathi believed the accused and deposited the money at SBI branch at Ramdaspet. But not only did they not give the contract, the money was not returned too, following which he lodged a complaint at the Sitapaldi police station. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBCN News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care of yourself and family.